RF transmitter design. The proposed transmitter utilizes the direct conversion architecture for its easiness of integration and low cost. As shown in Fig.9, it consists of a dual-mode IQLPF with mode switch circuits, an IQ-up conversion mixer with high linear voltage to current, V2I, units, a two-stage power driver amplifier, PA. Besides, the transimpedance amplifiers, TIAs, are integrated to measure the AC transfer character of the LPF. The main signal flow of this transmitter is as follows. The ABB, analog baseband, voltage signals from the DACs are applied at the inputs of the IQLPF. With the correct mode switch bit as well as the digital control capacitor array, DCCA, control word, the image signals of the DACs and the unwanted high-frequency spurs are all filtered out in both 264 MHz and 132 MHz modes. After the output voltages of the LPF are converted into ABB currents by V2I units, they are upconverted into RF voltages by the switches in the upconversion mixer at the rate of low. Lastly, the differential RF voltages are amplified by PA, power amplifier, and are converted into single-ended one via the 6 to 9 GHz off-chip balun, to drive the antenna. Block diagram of the proposed transmitter. The main requirements of this LPF are the attenuation of the outband signals, the in-band ripple, the dual-mode operation with accurate cutoff frequency controlling and accommodation to the large input ABB voltages. According to the sampling rate of a common UWB DAC, the LPF should have an attenuation of about 45 dB from 264/132nd of a MHz to 600/300th of a MHz at 264/132nd of a MHz mode. Moreover, an in-band ripple of half a decibel is required. To obtain comparably good phase linearity, the fifth-order Kepyshev GMC LPF is proposed. Besides, to deal with the ABB voltage as large as 300 mVPP, the passive sub-filter is placed as the first stage and the high Q biquad is as the last stage. Also, to improve the linearity of the LPF under low supply voltage with low power, the transconductors are built with a NADA structure, NADA B, et al., 1992. Architecture of the fifth-order Kepyshev LPF with mode switch circuits. The simplified IPath schematic of the upmixer is shown in Fig.11. It utilizes two double-balanced Gilbert cells with their output summed to realized single sideband, SSB, upmixing. Since the IQ upmixer acts as IQ modulator and upconversion mixer in direct conversion transmitter, the performances of the transmitter are mainly determined by this circuit. Low spurs, high linearity and wide bandwidth are the main challenges for the design of this upconversion mixer. The main spurs in the output spectrum of the transmitter are the low leakage and the sideband signal. The power of the low leakage is determined by the offset of the IQ-ABB path. In order to reduce the power of low leakage, an AC coupling is utilized between the V2I unit and the switches of the upmixer as shown in Figure 11. Besides, the linearity of the upmixer is mainly affected by the V2I unit while the impact of the switch stage is of less importance, Zhang Ren Liang, et al., 2009. Many techniques, Willy Sanson, 2006, have been proposed to improve the linearity of the V2I unit. Although the complete op-amp-assisted V2I possess better linearity, its application is restricted by the power consumption to achieve sufficient GBW gain bandwidth of the op-amp for UWB ABB as well as the limited voltage swing because of the low supply voltage. Instead, the simple op-amp assisted V2I unit is preferred. As shown in Fig.11, the V2I unit consists of the input MOS transistor M1, the source degeneration resistor R1, the current mirror transistor M2, M3, the AC coupling capacitor CB as well as the bias resistor for eliminating the DC offset in V2I. The feedback loop is composed of M1, R1, M2, I1 and I2, where M2 acts as the simple single transistor op-amp. When applied at the gate of M1, the input ABB voltage is directed transferred to the terminals of R1, because any voltage changes at the gate will be transferred to the source of M1 to maintain a fixed VGS as required by the current source I1 and I2. Thus the input voltage is converted linearly into its current counterpart with a gain of 1/R1. The converted current I circulates in M2. Then it is mirrored into the upmixer by M3. A 400 ohm 1 South African rand is used to improve the linearity at the cost of the gain loss in V2I. To compensate it, a 6 decibel gain is set at the current mirror. Furthermore, a broadband operation of the mixer is achieved by employing a differential inductor LD to peak with a parasitic capacitance PAR and two series resistors Rs to reduce Q of the overall load network. Simplified IPath schematic of the UP mixer and its wideband load network. Since the PA is the last stage of the transmitting chain, its linearity determines the output IP3 input third-order intercept point of the transmitter according to the Friis formula. Moreover, the PA should possess sufficient gain to boost the output power of the UP mixer as well as to reduce the impact of former stages on the linearity of the transmitter. A flat gain of the PA is desired, too. Besides, considerations of the rejection to common mode interferences should be taken because the tail current sources are eliminated to fit the low supply voltage. As shown in Fig.12, the first stage of the PA is a combination of source follower, M1, and common source, M2, amplifier, Chang Wen Kim, et al., 2005. The phase shift of the signal passing through the two amplifiers is 0 degrees and 180 degrees respectively. When the input signal VIN is applied at the two amplifiers, the common mode signals in VIN become out of phase and their amplitudes are subtracted at node XY while the differential mode signals in VIN become in phase and their amplitudes are added at node XY. In this configuration, the input differential signals are amplified with the common mode signals rejected. Therefore, the first stage increases the common mode rejection ratio, CMRR, of the transmitter. In order to obtain a high CMRR, the gain of the two appliers, i.e. the source follower and the common source amplifier, should be equal. The transistors M1 and M2 have the identical size. Under this condition, the ideal CMRR is infinite and the differential voltage gain is 6 dB. However, the post-simulation of this circuit indicates that the CMRR is improved by 12 dB and the differential voltage gain is about plus 2 dB because the inherent imbalances between the two amplifiers. Moreover, as the impact of the parasitic capacitors, the gain drops at high frequency. The second stage of the PA amplifies the RF signals to drive the off-chip balun. As the main amplification stage in this PA, its gain and linearity are important. Thus a Class A common source amplifier, MA, is employed. A differential inductor, LPA, with center tap is used as the load of this stage to resonate with the capacitance including the parasitic capacitance of MCA as well as the pad. Because the effective 50 ohm input resistors of balun 2 are part of the load network, its Q value is low and the gain is relatively flat. The value of the LPA is optimized according to the pad capacitance CP8 and the bonding inductance pound to ensure the peak of the gain is around 9 GHz instead of the middle of 6 to 9 GHz. Thus it compensates the gain drop of the first stage at high frequency. Besides, in this PA the cascode transistors, i.e. M3 and MC, ease the Miller effect to reduce the effective loading capacitance to the former stage and avoid the breakdown of the transistors during large signal period. 2-bit digital signals are used to select the required bias voltage for MA, and 8 dB variable gain is realized. Simplified schematic of 2-stage PA.